Welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we will discuss selecting the right inferencing option for deploying machine learning models on Amazon SageMaker. You may be wondering, what is inferencing? When you deploy your trained machine learning models to make predictions in real-world scenario or production environments is known as inferencing. Customers often have a hard time figuring out the best deployment strategy because every use case has different requirements like latency, throughput, payload size. Let's look at a real-world scenario and decide which option is the best in this use case. Say you have a banking customer working on a fraud detection project where they wanted to deploy a binary classification XGBoost model that has already been trained on their labeled dataset to quickly predict whether a transaction is fraudulent or not. This scenario experiences a constant traffic and a payload size of under 4 MB. The current deployed models have high response time, and they're struggling to find the right inferencing option which can process millions of transactions per second. Your customer has already spent months improving models' accuracy, and they do not want to spend additional time experimenting with the right deployment option. With that, let's dive deep into various Amazon SageMaker deployment options available and understand how to pick the best option based on your requirements. Your first option is SageMaker Real-Time Inference. This option is ideal for use cases that requires low latency and high throughput. In this option, you get a persistent and a fully managed endpoint that can handle sustained traffic. This endpoint is running on the instance type of your choice. Your application makes an inferencing request and get an immediate response. Real-time inference can support payload size up to 6 megabytes and processing time of 60 seconds. Some of the use cases are ad serving, personalized recommendations, and fraud detection, all of which that need fast response. Your second option is SageMaker Serverless Inference. It's best suitable for workload with intermittent or unpredictable traffic patterns. Unlike real-time scenario, in this option, you have idle periods between traffic bursts, and your workload should be able to tolerate cold starts. Serverless inference automatically launch compute resources and scale depending upon traffic, eliminating the need for you to choose instance types or manage scaling policies. Allow you to only pay for what you use. It can support payload size up to 4 megabytes and a processing time up to 60 seconds. Some of the examples are test workload, extracting and analyzing data from documents, form processing, and chatbot with unpredictable usage times. Your third option is SageMaker Asynchronous Inference. It's perfect for inferences when you want to queue requests and have large payload size up to 1 gigabyte or long processing time up to 15 minutes. You can scale down your endpoints to zero when there are no requests to process, which makes it a very cost-effective option. Few examples are computer vision, object detection. And a common theme with this choice is the ability to wait on inferencing or response. Your final option is SageMaker Batch Transform. It's available for offline processing when you have large amount of data and you do not need a persistent endpoint. Typically, it is used for pre-processing datasets. Compared to all the options discussed before, this has the highest throughput option available. It can support large datasets that are gigabytes in size and processing time up to days. Some of the examples are data pre-processing, churn prediction, and predictive maintenance. Coming back to the fraud detection use case, based on the requirements of low latency, high throughput, payload size being less than 4 megabytes, real-time prediction, you would use a SageMaker real-time inference. To do so, you create a SageMaker model from the trained model artifact. Then you configure a real-time inference endpoint by specifying few properties like EC2 instance types and counts. Then you deploy your model to the SageMaker hosting services and get an endpoint that can be used for inference in order to detect fraudulent transactions in real time. This endpoint is fully managed and support auto-scaling. As a best practice, make sure the instance size can handle the expected heavy traffic and latency requirements. End users will send an inference request and invoke the model for prediction. In response to the request, the model will generate a prediction and send it as a response in real time to the end user. In summary, it's important to gather relevant requirements like payload size, latency, request timeout, traffic patterns, so that you can decide which model deployment option is best for your specific use case. Check out the links in the description below for more details. See you next time.